All right, we're going to start here in a second. I wanted to tell y'all for the live stream link we have on our website, and Farm Bureau has it on all their Facebook page, so you can go to it and watch it right now. I think it's about to probably started right now. Can I get all the Farm Bureau agents to stand up? Anybody? Let's give them a huge round of applause, because we wouldn't be here without y'all and making this possible. We really appreciate all you do for the high school football in Arkansas. And this is our first year we're doing an offensive lineman award. Last year, Alan Thomason from Pulaski Academy was the 6A, 7A player of the year, offensive-wise. And we just thought, you know, there's so many offensive linemen that don't get enough recognition, and those are the guys that are the most fun to watch. I'm trying to think where my offensive linemen are. They're going to be the last, we saved the best for last. But if you've never watched a game from an offensive lineman standpoint of view, it is extremely entertaining to watch a season full of just an offensive lineman for 3 years. Every block, it was so much fun to watch, and we're just glad we can honor those guys tonight. We also, last year, we brought our first juniors we've ever done. We call it the Bo Embry Award. He told me you can't have an offensive player of the year without Traylon Burks as a junior. So last year we brought Dennis Gaines, Dax Goff, and Jalen Dupree. This year we've got the Archer brothers from Greenwood. Even though they're Kane, you're not a junior, you're a sophomore. Started as a freshman last year. But they're both brothers, and they were both 6A offensive player of the year and 6A defensive player of the year out of the whole conference, both brothers. And congratulations on a great year. We're just glad you're here. We wanted to, obviously people know about you. We're just glad you're here. You don't need us. But yes, so we're about to start with the 8-man coach of the year and 8-man player of the year.
Eight-man coach of the year. David Hendricks, Rector. Dave Hendricks was at Rector when the Cougars couldn't field a team for four seasons due to low numbers. But he stuck it out and led the Cougars to an 8-man state runner-up finish last season. Hendricks and the Cougars came back hungry for a title in 2023. Senior running back Caden Avery had 1,050 yards and 8 touchdowns this fall. And the defense gave up 12 points a game as Rector won a conference championship. And on a cold, rainy night, Avery ran 44 yards for a touchdown. And the Cougars used some trickery to storm back from a 16-point first quarter deficit and take down Spring Hill in overtime. That gave the Cougars an 11-0 record and their first state title in school history. Rector's Dave Hendricks. Eight-man player of the year. Drew Henderson, Rector. Drew Henderson was one of Rector's smallest players, but according to his coach, its biggest competitor. He took over at quarterback in the middle of last season, leading the Cougars to an 8-man runner-up finish. Henderson was Rector's most dynamic player this fall. He started on defense. And on offense, tallied almost 2,000 yards. In the state championship, this little man played big. In a driving rainstorm, he ran 32 times for 140 yards and 2 touchdowns, including this go-ahead score in overtime. Then he was in coverage on the final play as Rector completed an undefeated season and won its first state championship in school history. Rector's Drew Henderson.
With eight-man, it's a little anticlimactic. These are the winners. There's no debate. But Drew,
class
is 2A, ROTC,
offensive
going
player
to
of the
next year.
Year.
Congratulations on
Dennis Gaines,
of the year.
East Point
Coach
Sutt County.
Hendricks had 18 guys going into the last couple
Friday
weeks.
Night.
And brings up two
Dennis
freshmen
Gaines
to get his first state
East
championship.
County the past
and second
4 years,
state title game
was
in a row.
The focal point of
I wish
most
it would have been a little
players.
Better weather.
As a
but
sophomore,
it was,
number 24,
probably
had
nice
more than 1,400 yards
so congratulations.
And 17 touchdowns.
helping EPC advance to the quarterfinals. That was just a warm-up for his junior year when Dennis Gaines led the state.
Class 2A Offensive Player of the Year, Dennis Gaines, East Poinsett County. This warrior brought the fight every Friday night. Dennis Gaines started for East Poinsett County the past 4 years and was the focal point of most game plans. As a sophomore, number 24 had more than 1,400 yards and 17 touchdowns, helping EPC advance to the quarterfinals. That was just a warm-up for his junior year when Dennis Gaines led the state by rushing for almost 3,300 yards and 44 touchdowns, leading the Warriors to the semifinals for the first time in more than a decade. This fall, Gaines did it all. He made 95 tackles as East Poinsett County's head-hunting inside linebacker and was again the top offensive weapon. In the conference title game against rival Martree, Dennis gained 230 yards, and his touchdown run in overtime gave EPC its first conference title in 3 years. A month later, Gaines posted a team-best dozen tackles and generated 80 yards and one touchdown as East Poinsett County played in its first state title game. In four standout seasons, EPC's Dennis Gaines played for teams that won 36 games, two conference titles, finished as a runner-up in the state. East Poinsett County's Dennis Gaines. Caleb Elliott, Carlisle. Carlisle's Caleb Elliott spent two seasons backing up last year's Farm Bureau Awards winner, Jason Sullivan. This year, Caleb ran himself to the awards by churning out first downs and blasting for touchdowns. Caleb Elliott ran for more than 1,500 yards and 20 touchdowns this fall, as Carlisle won 11 games and advanced to the semifinals. Elliott also started on defense the past three seasons, fighting through blocks and making sure tackles in the open field. Last season, Elliott generated more than 300 yards and made 35 tackles on defense as Carlisle won 11 games and finished as state runner-up. In his career, All-State running back Caleb Elliott totaled more than 2,000 yards and 100 tackles, helping Carlisle reach double-digit victories in consecutive seasons and capture its first outright conference title in a dozen years. Carlisle's Caleb Elliott. Brett Neumeier, Bigelow. The son of a basketball and baseball coach, Bigelow's Brett Neumeier left his biggest mark on the football field as quarterback for the Panthers. Neumeier earned the starting job as a junior, rolling out to avoid pressure. He could also sit back in the pocket and arch long passes. Neumeier keyed a conference championship victory over Conway Christian by passing for 208 yards and three touchdowns. Brett became a true field general this fall, making quicker and more accurate decisions. He had a lot of offensive weapons and used them all, leading Bigelow to another conference championship. In a remarkable four-game playoff run, Brett Neumeier passed for almost 900 yards. He completed 5 of 9 passes for 133 yards and 2 touchdowns in just the first quarter of the state championship game. In his two-time all-conference career, Brett Neumeier passed for more than 4,200 yards and 50 touchdowns, leading Bigelow to 34 wins and its first state championship as he earned title game MVP honors with 200 yards passing. Bigelow's Brett Neumeier.
All right, Dennis. This Dennis Gaines. He is committed to play for UCA next year. He is. Last year, he led the state in rushing yards. Brett Neumeier. I got to do a podcast with him last week. He carried the between the mats with us, And Caleb, your tackle at last year's semifinal against Mount Ida got you to the finals. That was awesome. And so the 2A Offensive Player of the Year goes to Dennis Gaines. We have Colton Tosh, who played every position on the field. He played quarterback, receiver, tight end, running back, defensive end, did it all. We have, Colton Tosh, Carter Alexander, whose brother was a finalist my first year and from Bigelow, and it's great to see you back here. Again, you were there at the old place. And Luke Petras. Your five solo tackles against Mount Ida was huge, along with that win. And so the Farm Bureau Defensive Player of the Year goes to Carter Alexander.
He returned to his alma mater and was the Scrappers' defensive coordinator for the 2015 state title team. 7 years later, Cheshire took over just down the road at Murfreesboro before last season and quickly helped the Rattlers slither up the 3AA conference ladder. Cheshire chiseled a defensive identity into his team. The Rattlers allowed just 8 points a game, holding nine teams to one touchdown or less. Murfreesboro limited opponents' possessions with a strong running attack that averaged 269 yards per game. In a Week 10 showdown with Mineral Springs, a jam-packed house watched Cheshire's Rattlers pull off a 12-6 overtime victory with a masterful defensive effort and give Murfreesboro its first outright conference championship since 2009. Murfreesboro's Brad Cheshire. Brandon Powell, East Poinsett County. In 8 seasons, Coach Brandon Powell has taken East Poinsett County from the conference basement to playing in the biggest game. East Poinsett County won 3 games in 2015. Powell took over the next season, and the Warriors haven't posted a losing record since. They won a conference title in 2020, and the next season beat Quitman in the playoffs to advance to the quarterfinals. A year ago, the Warriors scored 46 points in an early season showdown with Walnut Ridge and ran to the semifinals for the first time in 11 years. This fall, Powell made his defense more athletic by moving 2 seniors to linebacker. The Warriors responded by giving up no more than 2 touchdowns in 4 games. Senior quarterback Cooper Argo passed for 1,600 yards and 16 touchdowns as EPC averaged 40 points a game, won its second conference title in a decade, and advanced to the state title game for the first time in school history. East Poinsett County's Brandon Powell. Luke Starks, Bigelow. His last name is synonymous with Bigelow football. Luke Starks played for his dad, Jeff Starks, at Bigelow before becoming head coach himself in 2019. Starks molded this year's Panthers into title contenders with a smothering defense that only gave up 14 points weekly. In the conference championship game against Conway Christian, junior Jaden Dunlop returned an interception for a crucial touchdown, helping Bigelow escape with a 7-point victory and giving Starks' team a 4th consecutive conference title. A solid offensive line allowed quarterback Rhett Neumeyer time to pass the ball. 4 different receivers caught at least 5 touchdown passes. In the state title game, Bigelow had 5 receivers catch passes and tallied almost 200 yards through the air. A senior-heavy Bigelow roster hoped for a payoff season, and 30-year-old Luke Starks made sure they cashed it in, resulting in the Panthers' first-ever state championship. Bigelow's Luke Starks.
Coach Cheshire, if you went to a pregame of his team, have you ever heard Delta Dawn? A bunch of 16-year-old, 17-year-old kids listen to that for a game. It's the most entertaining thing you'll see. Coach Powell, losing 4 linemen from last year's semifinal team, getting to the finals, but you do have another little Dennis Gaines, another Gaines coming up, so we're excited. And Coach Starks, the second youngest coach in history to win a state championship, congratulations. And the Farm Bureau Coach of the Year goes to Luke Starks.
set a school record, rushing for more than 2,300 yards and 29 touchdowns, helping the Bearcats back to the state title game for the first time since 2019. This fall, Dax ruled. He ran for more than 200 yards in a mid-October conference title showdown win at defending state champion Charleston. And 5 weeks later in the quarterfinals, went for 200 yards at Harmony Grove, Washington County. In the semifinals against Glen Rose, Goff fooled everyone by throwing a touchdown pass. And he also ran for 157 yards and 2 scores. On a sunny Saturday afternoon in War Memorial Stadium, Dax Goff earned championship game MVP honors by rushing 31 times for 245 yards and 3 touchdowns. Boonville's all-state performer in 3 sports finished his senior season with 95 tackles, accounted for more than 2,900 yards and 45 touchdowns, leading tradition-rich Boonville to its 5th-ever state championship. Boonville's Dax Goff. Heath Balance, Glen Rose. Glen Rose's top running back took hits, but didn't fall on first contact, so you could say number 22 was appropriately named, Heath Balance. In an all-state junior season, Balance ran for more than 1,400 yards and 18 touchdowns, helping Glen Rose to its first conference title in 3 years. This fall, Heath balanced the workload between running back and free safety. He averaged 11 and a half yards every time he touched the ball. Balance carried the ball 14 times for a mind-blowing 302 yards and 5 touchdowns in the conference title game victory over Centerpoint in late October. 5 weeks later, Balance and the Beavers went to the semifinals of the state playoffs, where Heath had 202 yards and 2 touchdowns at Boonville. In 2 all-state seasons, Glen Rose's rugged running back, Heath Balance, gained more than 3,400 yards and totaled 56 touchdowns, helping the Beavers to 19 wins and back-to-back conference titles. Glen Rose's Heath Balance. Caleb Johnson, Harmony Grove, Washita County. He started some as a freshman and was all-state as a sophomore, but Caleb Johnson came into his own as Harmony Grove's quarterback the past 2 seasons. His throws became more accurate as a junior when he passed for more than 1,800 yards and 18 touchdowns. He also scrambled for almost 800 yards, helping the Hornets to a conference runner-up finish. He switched to number 8 this fall, but still kept plays alive in the pocket and delivered pinpoint passes. His touchdown pass with 1 minute left in the 6-3A championship game gave Harmony Grove a 29-28 win over Fordyce. In 3 all-state seasons, Harmony Grove gunslinger Caleb Johnson passed for more than 5,500 yards and 67 touchdowns. And he ran for more than 2,000 yards and 38 touchdowns, helping the Hornets to 1 conference championship and a trip to the quarterfinals. Harmony Grove's Caleb Johnson.
All right. Dax Goff led the state in home runs last year in 3A in baseball, along with all the things he did in football. Caleb Johnson, a 3-time All-State quarterback. That's tough to do. Heath Balance, 11 and a half yards of carry. That's insane. The 3A Offensive Player of the Year, the Farm Bureau 3A Offensive Player of the Year goes to Dax Goff.
Player of the Year, Jamarian Burton Prescott. defensive linemen aren't supposed to be sprinters on state championship track teams. But few are like Prescott's Jamarian Burton. He ran down plays and made plenty of them in the backfield. As a sophomore, Burton had 50 stops. Then he got bigger and quicker as a junior when he made 85 tackles, 21 of them coming behind the line of scrimmage. As a senior, Burton had 8 stops in a Mercy Rule Conference title game victory at Junction City. 2 months later, he made 7 stops in the quarterfinals at Bismarck, then racked up 10 tackles in a semifinal victory over Mansfield. In the state championship game, Burton racked up 9 stops. And in an all-state senior season, Prescott's Jamarian Burton had 102 tackles and 18 sacks, helping Prescott to 13 wins and a trip to the state title game. Prescott's Jamarian Burton. Marishka, Charleston. Charleston's strongest player was also its best leader. Reese Marishka ran through defenses while playing offense and made open field tackles look easy on defense. A 3-year starter on both sides of the ball, Reese helped Charleston win 10 games and a conference championship as a sophomore. A year later, Reese was a key ingredient on Charleston's 2022 state title team, finishing with 1,000 yards rushing and 52 tackles. Charleston's most physical player forced fumbles and intercepted passes as a senior. On offense, he broke some long runs, rushing for 163 yards weekly. In a 2-time All-State career, Reese Marishka racked up more than 130 tackles, generated more than 3,400 yards of offense while scoring 50 touchdowns, making the Tigers to 31 wins, 2 conference titles, and 1 state championship. Charleston's Reese Marishka. Carmelo Allen, Fordyce. Quarterbacks could run, but they couldn't hide from the 6'3" defensive force from Fordyce. As a sophomore, Carmelo Allen made nearly 100 tackles and led the Red Bucks to a state runner-up finish. Faster as a junior, Allen shot the gaps at linebacker, finished with 98 tackles, as the Red Bucks earned a conference runner-up finish. He lined up all over the field as a senior. Allen blocked and caught passes at receiver. In the conference title game in late October, on defense, Allen lived in Harmony Grove's backfield. 3 weeks later, he was just unblockable at Prescott, where he recorded 3 sacks, 9 total tackles. Carmelo Allen finishes his 2-time All-State career at Fordyce with 20 sacks and more than 300 tackles. Fordyce's Carmelo Allen.
The Allen brothers you're going to hear a lot next year. He got to play with his younger brother, who probably will be a finalist here, and they were both making some plays in the backfield. Reese, that was the furthest I've ever seen a fumble hit. That highlight, it was. I don't think I've seen one that far. Burton, I don't think Boonville allowed a sack all season. That was the first time that was impressive in the state championship game. The Farm Bureau Insurance 3A Defensive Player of the Year goes to Reese Marishka.
Turning points. For Prescott's Brian Glass this year, the turning point game was week 5 at Traditional Power Junction City. Glass's Curly Wolves pounced on the Dragons to the tune of a 42-7 halftime advantage. They outgained Junction City by more than 100 yards and held the Dragons to only one touchdown until late in the game. From there, the Curly Wolves just got better. In the second round of the playoffs, Prescott played longtime nemesis Fordyce for the second time this season. Clinging to a one-point lead in the final minute, Prescott's defense stopped a two-point conversion try. 2 weeks later, riding the arms and legs of senior quarterback Pierce Yates, the Curly Wolves down Mansfield in the semifinals, advancing to their second state championship game appearance in 3 years. In 4 years, Glass and the Curly Wolves have won 48 games and 4 straight conference titles. Prescott's Brian Glass. Whit Overton, Mansfield. Mansfield native Whit Overton worked at Walmart for 5 years before going back to college to become a coach. 13 years later, Overton returned home and orchestrated one of the state's biggest turnarounds. The Tigers totaled just 10 wins the previous 3 seasons before his arrival. Overton installed the flexbone offense, and Mansfield's confidence grew throughout the season. 160-pound senior team leader Tyler Turnipseed shifted from receiver to halfback and ran for almost 1,000 yards and 11 touchdowns. Junior Daniel Burton banged out 1,800 yards and 21 touchdowns as the Tigers averaged 35 points per game. Linebacker Jeremy Stosier played quarterback and led the Tigers in tackles, while Turnipseed led the Tigers in interceptions and had more than 40 tackles, as Mansfield won a school record 11 games in 2023 and advanced to the semifinals for the first time in school history. Mansfield's Whit Overton. Doc Crowley, Boonville. Boonville graduated 16 players after advancing to last year's state championship game, but having to start sophomores at 9 positions this fall didn't faze coach Doc Crowley. In week 8 at Charleston, Boonville's sophomores grew up. With 5 sophomores starting on defense, the Bearcats held Charleston to 262 yards and 15 points as Boonville secured its 5th conference title in 6 seasons. In the quarterfinals at Harmony Grove, Washita County, Boonville ran out to a 24-0 lead in the first half and cruised to a 28-point win. A week later, Boonville broke open a close game with Glenn Rose in the second half by going to the air. And on Saturday afternoon at War Memorial Stadium, Doc Crowley and the young Boonville Bearcats won their 13th game of the season and first state title since 2019. Boonville's Doc Crowley.
All right, so this is the first time I've seen Coach Glass without a toothpick. We went and got, okay, good. So Coach Overton, who was at Boonville last year, takes him to the semifinals, an amazing job. And Coach Doc Crowley, you need to watch that close up, because when he throws his hat at the end, you need to get a good view at the end of the video and kind of rewind it. It's awesome. But the 3A, the Farm Bureau Insurance 3A Coach of the Year goes to Whit Overton.
Helping the Elks accumulate double-digit wins for the first time in
times in junior high, but when Malvern needed a running
back. Years ago, Jalen Dupree took the ball and ran. The rest is history and is in the history books. As a sophomore, Dupree carried Malvern to a playoff win at DeWitt by running for 290 yards and three touchdowns. Number two was just warming up. The next season, Jalen etched his name as a Malvern legend. On a gloomy Saturday in December, Jalen Dupree made two crucial sacks on defense and ran 35 times for 287 yards and four touchdowns, helping Malvern win its second-ever state championship. This fall, Dupree dominated. He ran for more than 150 yards in every game, helping Malvern to a conference runner-up finish. In a three-time All-State career, Jalen Dupree became the state's third all-time leading rusher with more than 6,800 yards. He accounted for 99 total touchdowns while playing for teams that won 25 games and one state championship. Malvern's Jalen Dupree. Kyler Hoover, Harding Academy. He experienced what most high school athletes only dream of, finishing every season of his high school career playing in the state championship game. For the past three seasons, Kyler Hoover was vital to Harding Academy's success. A two-way starter as a sophomore, Hoover starred in the secondary and had more than 400 yards as slot receiver as the Wildcats won 13 games and a state championship. Focusing on offense his junior year, the elusive Kyler Hoover generated almost 1,300 yards and 19 touchdowns during a 12-win campaign. That set Hoover up for a remarkable senior season. Kyler Hoover had more than 1,500 yards and 20 touchdowns, helping Harding Academy win another conference title. He finishes his career with more than 3,000 yards for teams that won 40 games and two state championships. Harding Academy's Kyler Hoover.
I would like to see Coach Evans. I'd like to see Kyler if you needed him more in the secondary. He only put him in when he absolutely needed to, and he showed out. Dizzy, I remember a stat with Dizzy. He had 37 touchdowns and 41 incompletions at one point, which is insane. And Malvern, Dupree, he just got here, so I just got the note. He is going to sign with Colorado State. He had Ole Miss and Mississippi State here. That's why he was late. So they just left his house, I guess. That must have been tough telling him no, right? The Farm Bureau Offensive Player of the Year for 4A goes to Dizzy Dean.
Class 4A Defensive Player of the Year. K.D. Young, Arkadelphia. Arkadelphia's defensive chess piece, always moving to match up against the opponent's best offensive lineman. Whether it was making tackles or big plays, K.D. Young won most of those battles. Wearing number 51 as a freshman, Young rotated into the lineup in the playoffs, making two sacks in a 27-point win over Mena. A year later, KD had 76 tackles as Arkadelphia won 10 games and went to the semifinals. Switching to number 53 as a junior, he made 85 stops, helping the Badgers to 11 victories and another trip to the semifinals. This fall, Young dominated so much he played in only the first half of seven blowout victories. He still managed to register 62 tackles and seven sacks. In a three-time All-State career, Arkadelphia's K.D. Young racked up 22 sacks and more than 230 tackles for teams that won nine playoff games and two conference championships.
Kobe Turner, Rivercrest.
This guy was a difference maker for Rivercrest, whether it was making big hits or taking handoffs to the house.
Kobe Turner was involved in most big plays for the Colts over the past three seasons. Turner tallied more than 1,300 yards and 21 touchdowns as a junior, helping the Colts win 9 games and advance to the quarterfinals of the playoffs. An ankle injury slowed Turner early this year, but once he started, no one could slow number 2. In a 10-point semifinal victory over Warren, Kobe Turner etched his name in Rivercrest lore by making 5 tackles and running 29 times for 261 yards and 2 scores. This fall, Turner exploded for more than 1,700 yards and racked up more than 70 tackles, taking Rivercrest to a conference championship, 11 wins, and the state championship game. Rivercrest, Kobe Turner. Wyatt Simmons, Harding Academy. Four-year starters are not common, but those who finish all 4 years playing for a state title are even more rare. So players like Harding Academy's Wyatt Simmons are almost non-existent. He played defensive end as a freshman, and the Wildcats beat McGee for the Class 3A title. A year later, Simmons was on offense when the Wildcats won their second straight state championship. Then all it took was a few practice snaps at linebacker last year, and the rest was history. Simmons finished his all-state junior season by forcing 3 turnovers and making 84 tackles, helping Harding Academy to a state runner-up finish. This fall, a focused Wyatt Simmons still dabbled on offense, but he excelled on defense, where he chased down ball carriers and delivered big hits. One of the state's top linebackers, Simmons recorded more than 90 tackles as a senior, helping Harding Academy to 15 wins and its third state title in 4 seasons. Harding Academy's Wyatt Simmons.
All right. Well, Kobe Turner is sick tonight, so Coach Fleming is going to be here representing him. And Katie Young, his defensive line coach texted me the other day and said he's only been at Arkadelphia and had to use a lineman. He said he's going to have to start learn how to coach D-line. That's, you spoiled it for him. And Wyatt Simmons, if you don't know his recruiting story, it's the craziest story I've seen. He made a film, I guess, in March on a Friday night, and they sent it out. And then I think Tuesday, every airplane from every major school in the world is coming to Searcy, Arkansas. He had probably 20 offers by Tuesday, and everyone's scheduling flights to come see it. And now you've committed to the University of Arkansas. But Harding still has a shot, right? Okay. His dad's working on this, talking to his mom. But so the Farm Bureau 4A Defensive Player of the Year goes to Wyatt Simmons.
Class 4A Coach of the Year. Neil Evans, Harding Academy.
There's no argument about it. Coach Neil Evans has turned Harding Academy into one of the state's more dominant teams the past 5 years. The Wildcats won 3 consecutive Class 3A crowns before jumping up to Class 4A last season. A loss to Malvern in that state title game left Harding hungry. In this year's opener against eventual 5A East champ Valley View, junior quarterback Owen Miller and the Wildcat offense was unstoppable, totaling 515 yards and 8 touchdowns in a 15-point victory. Miller and junior running back Isaac Baker were key cogs for an offense that averaged 44 points a game this fall. And on Saturday night at War Memorial Stadium, in the final game of the season, Neil Evans and the Harding Academy Wildcats won their 67th game and 4th state championship the past 5 years. Harding Academy's Neil Evans.
Zach Watson, Elkins.
He built the state's top offense the past two seasons, but the architect, Zach Watson, doesn't take the credit. He says he just utilized the tools. Last fall, the Elks put up 50 points a game, passing for 250 yards weekly. This year, the Elks were even more prolific, averaging 53 points a game. Two-time All-State running back Deshaun Chairs was unleashed in the playoffs. Chairs went off for 250 yards and five touchdowns in a quarterfinal victory at Central Arkansas Christian. And he finished the season with more than 1,900 yards and 39 touchdowns. But it wasn't just the offense. Watson's Elks got defensive, holding 11 opponents to two touchdowns or less. In three seasons, Zach Watson and his high-powered Elks have won 31 games and back-to-back conference championships. Elkins, Zach Watson. Johnny Fleming, Rivercrest. Rivercrest coach Johnny Fleming knows the state title game formula. Run the ball and play tough defense. Those are things he learned in 30 years as an assistant when the Colts made five title game appearances. Earlier this fall, Fleming predicted his Colts would end the season back in War Memorial Stadium. Two early September non-conference losses by a combined 47 points didn't deter the Colts. They kept running. Athletic senior Michael Rayner stormed his way to more than 1,500 yards, helping the Colts average 40 points per game. Seniors Marcus Slayton and Wyatt Lancaster were leaders on a defense that held 12 opponents to two touchdowns or less. In the semifinals against previously unbeaten Warren, Rivercrest stymied the Lumberjacks' high-powered offense, holding Warren to minus 19 yards rushing. And 4 months after his prediction, the Colts made Fleming's preseason prognostication come true with another trip to the state title game. Rivercrest, Johnny Fleming.
Coach Evans has been here more than Farm Bureau, I think. He's a fixture here. Coach Watson has led the state in points per game for 2 years in a row. And Coach Fleming, scheduling the toughest non-conference you can I'm just looking at those non-conference, to get ready for a postseason run. That's kind of what I think about Rivercrest, making runs at the end. And the 4A Coach of the Year, the Farm Bureau 4A Coach of the Year goes to Zach Watkins Elkins.
Last 5A Offensive Player of the Year. Carson Turley, Valley View. As Valley View signal caller before his sophomore season. And Carson Turley eventually turned from game manager into game breaker. As a junior, Turley learned to put touch on his passes, like this nifty throw that lifted Valley View to a 7-point win over Southside. Turley accounted for more than 2,700 yards and 29 touchdowns a year ago, helping Valley View to 9 wins, a conference championship, and just the second quarterfinal appearance in school history. This fall, the dual threat Turley tortured defenses. In the opener at Harding Academy, Carson Turley dazzled. In less than 3 quarters of action, he accounted for 500 yards and 5 touchdowns. 2 weeks later, Carson put up 325 yards and 2 touchdowns in a 22-point win over Rivercrest. In 3 All-State seasons, Carson Turley tallied more than 7,100 yards and 84 TDs, helping Valley View to 26 wins and consecutive conference championships.
Bo Williams, Shiloh Christian.
Shiloh Christian's vocal leader and hardest worker ran with purpose for 3 seasons. Bo Williams consistently broke tackles and outraced defenders. As a sophomore, Bo's emergence helped Shiloh Christian post 13 wins and a state runner-up finish. In an All-State Junior campaign, Bo blasted for more than 1,900 yards and 34 touchdowns, running Shiloh Christian back to the state championship game. Injuries and illness cropped up this year and could have derailed his senior season, but Bo wouldn't stay down. Playing on a tender ankle, Bo gutted out 20 carries for 170 yards and 6 touchdowns in a midseason win over Pea Ridge. In the first round of the playoffs, he had 16 carries for 121 yards in just the first half of a Mercy Rule win over Hot Springs. And at Pine Bluff in the semifinals, the Saints hitched their wagon to Bo Williams in the second half, and Bo pulled them to an 8-point win. He carried the ball 41 times for 269 yards and 5 touchdowns. In a 2-time All-State career, Shiloh Christian's Bo Williams generated almost 4,500 yards and 79 touchdowns for teams that won 37 games and made it to 3 straight state championship game appearances. Shiloh Christian's Bo Williams.
Courtney Crutchfield, Pine Bluff. He wore number 2, but the past 4 years, Courtney Crutchfield was Pine Bluff's number 1 option. He lined up everywhere on offense and knew how to get open. As a junior two-way starter, Crutchfield had almost 1,000 yards and made 30 tackles at cornerback, helping the Zebras post a winning record for the first time in 5 years. This fall, Crutchfield focused more on offense and was Pine Bluff's dynamic playmaker, leading the Zebras to their first conference title in 6 seasons. In the semifinals, Crutchfield almost single-handedly took down Shiloh Christian, catching 7 passes for 220 yards and 3 touchdowns. He also made 2 tackles and this interception in the end zone. In a 2-time All-State career, Pine Bluff's Mr. Do-It-All, Courtney Crutchfield, registered more than 60 tackles and generated 3,500 yards and 45 touchdowns while helping Pine Bluff football return to prominence.
We got to do a scholar-athlete video with Carson Turley of Valley View, a 4.0. Bo Williams ran for 400 yards against Little Rock Christian. That's insane. Sorry, Preston. Courtney Crutchfield was named last year as the Arkansas Democrat Gazette Male Athlete of the Year after earning All-State in 3 different sports. It's insane. The Farm Bureau Insurance 5A Offensive Player of the Year goes to Courtney Crutchfield.
Class 5A Defensive Player of the Year. Charleston Collins Mills, making plays in the backfield. And hearing his name on the loudspeaker were common the past 2 years for this lightning-fast Mills Comet. As a junior, Charleston Collins had 10 stops against Maumelle, then made 2 sacks and 8 tackles in a 1-point victory over Pine Bluff. He finished an All-State junior campaign with 12 sacks and a whopping 124 tackles. Collins flew to the ball as a tenacious senior. In midseason at Maumelle, Collins camped out in the backfield, recording 8 tackles and a sack among 3 tackles for loss. A week later, he was unblockable in Pine Bluff with 12 tackles and 4 sacks to key a 3-point Mills victory over the Zebras. In 2 All-State seasons, defensive lineman Charleston Collins collected 239 tackles and 24 sacks for teams that won 20 games and twice advanced to the quarterfinals. Austin Dindy, Pine Bluff. As part of Pine Bluff's 1-2-3 punch, he was number 1, and Austin Dindy rarely came off the field. Coach Michael Williams says the most exciting Pine Bluff Zebra could have been the state's best running back.
But number one was too valuable to play just one position. As a junior, he developed into one of the state's top safeties, totaling more than 30 tackles. And he was one of the top receivers, with 600 yards of offense. Dindy just took off this season. When Pine Bluff's quarterback got hurt in the first half of the playoff game against Nettleton, Austin took snaps as signal caller, running for 84 yards and two TDs. In an all-state senior season, Austin Dindy played three positions on offense, tallying more than 1,000 yards and 16 touchdowns. And on defense, he was the Zebras' most dynamic player, never coming off the field on that side of the ball. Austin Dindy helped the Zebras to their first conference title in 6 years and a trip to the playoff semifinals. Brian Huff, Valley View. This 6'3" tackling machine is hard to miss. That's why Valley View coaches used Brian Huff all over the field. Playing inside linebacker for the first time as a junior, Brian Huff amassed 92 tackles. In a late October showdown with Southside, his strip and fumble recovery helped seal a 7-point victory. This fall, Huff excelled at rushing the passer and disrupting plays. He registered 78 tackles and was the main force for a defense that held four opponents to a touchdown or less. In three all-state seasons, Brian Huff amassed 245 tackles and created 9 turnovers, helping Valley View win back-to-back 5A East championships.
All right, I want you to think about this. This category is absolutely loaded. Austin Dindy committed to the University of Missouri. Brian Huff committed to the University of Missouri. And Charleston Collins in the middle there committed to the University of Arkansas. This is an absolutely loaded category. The 2023 Farm Bureau Insurance 5A Defensive Player of the Year goes to Charleston Collins Mills. And Austin's teammate, Crutchfield, is going to Missouri next weekend on a visit. So hopefully it doesn't go as well as the one in Fayetteville. Talk about.
Class 5A Coach of the Year. Tucker Barnard, Shiloh Christian. He coordinated Shiloh Christian's defense when the Saints won 3 straight state titles more than a decade ago. Tucker Barnard returned to Shiloh as head coach this past July with championship expectations. Battling key injuries in midseason, the Saints put up 533 yards and 57 points in a victory over Pea Ridge. A month later, the Saints were mostly healed and played their best game of the season, scoring 51 points in the first half and hammering Hot Springs in the first round of the playoffs. In the semifinals, the Saints trailed talented Pine Bluff by 16 points at halftime. But behind the steady play of ninth grade quarterback Cole Creighton, the Saints scored 4 second half touchdowns, and the defense allowed only 1 score. Shiloh prevailed 49-41, advancing to its 5th straight state title game. Shiloh Christian's Tucker Barnard.
Brad Boulding, Parkview.
Sometimes the hardest part is staying on top. That was not the case this fall for Coach Brad Boulding and Little Rock Parkview. The Patriots were picked to defend last year's state title, and they never misfired, running through 14 opponents by an average margin of 37 points per game. Senior quarterback Eric McGee passed for more than 1,800 yards and 20 touchdowns. In the state title game, McGee led the offense to 6 touchdowns before the middle of the third quarter when the starters left the game. The defense was even better this season. Parkview forced 19 turnovers, recorded 31 sacks, and held 12 opponents to 2 touchdowns or less. Parkview completed its first ever undefeated season
with its second straight state championship. Little Rock Parkview's Brad Boulding. Garen Rockwell, Hot Springs Lakeside. He was defensive coordinator for three conference championship teams at Hot Springs Lakeside before getting promoted to head coach in the spring. Garen Rockwell instantly revived a stale program. Rockwell's Rams swarmed on defense. The offense rode the arm of senior team leader and quarterback Jacob Hermosillo to 36 points a week. In a September showdown with Camden Fairview, senior Kyle Wolf ran for 160 yards and two touchdowns, helping the Rams gain 400 yards in a 14-point victory. In the first round of the playoffs against Harrison, Hermosillo passed for more than 300 yards and three touchdowns, and junior Grady Oman ran for 185 yards and two scores, as the Rams scored 58 points and gained almost 600 yards, advancing to the quarterfinals for the third time in 40 years.
Coach Bernard only came here 20 years ago. He was coaching basketball out of college, and it's only because his wife got a job at Dillard's, so I know Shiloh's very glad. Coach Rockwell, his wife, he told us his wife prayed for three wins. Instead, they had two last year. This is his first job, so they wanted three. And he got a lot more than that. And Coach Boulding, your first undefeated state championship with Parkview, and did it with a lot of juniors and sophomores. And also scheduling. Anybody, you're looking for week one, is that correct?
Zero.
Week zero, okay. Probably a bad time to say that then. But so the Farm Bureau 5A offensive or 5A coach of the year goes to Brad Boulding, Parkview. I need to get with Greenwood.
Class 6A Offensive Player of the Year. Braden Davis, Greenwood.
Greenwood's fifth team running back as a sophomore and moved up as a junior but still played sparingly. Now everyone in Greenwood knows about Braden Davis. He transformed himself in the weight room and on the field. Davis' coming out party was week four against Siloam Springs when he caught a short touchdown pass and ran 20 times for 243 yards and three touchdowns. A week later, Davis had 92 yards and two touchdowns at Van Buren. Braden Davis came up big in the conference title game, banging out 121 yards against Little Rock Christian, running 28 times for 155 yards. In an all-state senior season, Greenwood's Braden Davis ran 237 times for almost 1,600 yards and 22 touchdowns without a single fumble, helping Greenwood to both conference and state championships. Greenwood's Braden Davis. Braylon Russell, Benton. He saved his best for Benton's biggest games, and Braylon Russell delivered. For instance, last year's 7-point semifinal loss at Greenwood when he ran for 260 yards. And he was just as clutch this fall. In an early season showdown with defending 6A East champion Little Rock Catholic, Braylon sparked a 7-point win by running for 160 yards. 2 weeks later, he amassed more than 100 yards in a mercy rule victory over previously unbeaten Marion. And it wasn't just in big games. Braylon banged out first downs and tough yards every week. And he improved his pass catching, which helped Benton's offense put up 50 points per game. In two All-State seasons, Benton's big back ran for almost 3,000 yards and 46 touchdowns, taking the Panthers to 20 wins, a conference title, and consecutive trips to the semifinals. Benton's Braylon Russell. Walker White, Little Rock Christian. 4 days after this year's final game, Walker White was working out on his own during school. That work ethic separated Little Rock Christian's quarterback from the others. White won a starting job as a sophomore and totaled 2,500 yards and 28 touchdowns, running the Warriors to 10 wins and a trip to the semifinals. The intense leader accounted for 3,000 yards and 44 touchdowns as an All-State junior. This fall, White was even better. In the conference opener against Lake Hamilton, he had 344 yards and 6 TDs in a 28-point win. The next week, he helped Little Rock Christian clear the Pulaski Academy hurdle by eluding the Bruin defense and passing for 267 yards and 5 touchdowns in a 42-point victory. In the conference championship game at Greenwood, White had 373 yards. And in the state championship game a month later, he accounted for 402 yards and 3 scores. For his career, Walker White generated more than 8,700 yards and a whopping 110 touchdowns and earned All-State honors twice. Little Rock Christian's Walker White.
All right. Braylon Russell committed to the University of Arkansas. There we go. Braden Davis in the final game in the state championship, Coach Young didn't give it to anybody else but him to seal the game. He hasn't fumbled in his entire career, and Coach knew that to seal it. Congratulations on the state championship. Walker White committed to Auburn. War Eagle. And that hurdle, I think you impressed the refs so much they didn't call the hurdle on that. The Farm Bureau 6A Offensive Player of the Year goes to Walker White, Little Rock Christian.
Class 6A Defensive Player of the Year. Brady Mackey, Greenwood. Greenwood's Brady Mackey had the skills to be a receiver. That's why the Ball Hawk stood out at safety. He was physical enough to make plays behind the line of scrimmage and athletic enough to go up after passes. In an All-State junior season, Mackey made 143 tackles and this interception, boosting Greenwood to 10 wins and a state runner-up finish. Mackey was a ball magnet this fall, routinely intercepting passes near the goal line. In Greenwood's 17-point victory over Little Rock Christian in the conference title game, Mackey made 9 stops and intercepted 2 passes. A month later, number 4 had 5 stops and his 6th interception of the season, helping Greenwood win a state championship. During a 2-time All-State career, Greenwood's Brady Mackey had 220 tackles and 7 interceptions for teams that won 32 games, 2 conference championships, and 1 state title. Greenwood's Brady Mackey.
Chris Bernard, Benton. Benton's team leader never wanted to come off the field. That's why Chris Bernard did it all. He ran the ball and excelled on defense. Last season, he filled in at running back, going for more than 100 yards in a 17-point victory over West Memphis. This fall, Bernard still helped on offense and was voted the top defensive back in the 6A East by smothering receivers, making a team-high 119 tackles and 6 interceptions. In 3 seasons, Chris Bernard racked up more than 250 tackles and twice earned All-State honors while helping Benton win 29 games and 2 conference championships. Benton's Chris Bernard. Preston Davis, Little Rock Christian.
Little Rock Christian's most energetic player was also its defensive leader. In most games, Preston Davis was the top tackler. During an all-conference sophomore season, Davis made 148 tackles, helping the Warriors capture 10 wins and advance to the semifinals. When Little Rock Christian moved up to Class 6A last season, Davis also stepped up, becoming more physical. He made 109 stops as the Warriors went to the quarterfinals. This fall, he rocked opponents. Davis had 11 tackles in midseason against Pulaski Academy and made 9 stops in the conference championship game against Greenwood. A month later, in the state title game, Preston Davis had a game-high 16 tackles. Davis dominated as an all-state senior with 132 tackles. In his career, hard-hitting, Preston Davis made 359 tackles, helping the Warriors to 29 wins and a state runner-up finish. Little Rock Christian's Preston Davis.
Brady had a pick six against Pulaski Academy in the semifinals that I was instructed by my brother, who is the offensive coordinator, not to show in that video. Yeah, so Preston Davis carried the hammer, more energy than anyone I've seen, carried the hammer outside the tunnel runouts. Chris Bernard, 6A East Defensive Back of the Year. The 2023 Farm Bureau Insurance 6A Defensive Player of the Year goes to Brady Mackey, Greenwood. Nice.
Class 7A Offensive Player of the Year, Carter Nye, Bentonville. Changing plays at the line of scrimmage and extending them with his legs were traits of Bentonville gunslinger Carter Nye. In an all-conference junior season, Nye was Bentonville's difference maker, zipping precision passes for first downs and stretching defenses with deep passes. In the conference title game with Fayetteville, his play-action bootleg pass for the winning two-point conversion in overtime lifted the Tigers to their sixth conference title in 7 seasons. 7 weeks later, Nye and the Tigers returned to the state title game for the first time since 2017. This fall, Carter Nye kept plays alive by scrambling out of the pocket and stepping up under pressure. Nye passed for 238 yards and 4 touchdowns in a semifinal win over 7A Central champion Bryant. In the state championship game a week later, Nye gave Bentonville a chance by passing for 329 yards and 2 touchdowns. In 2 seasons as a full-time starter, Bentonville's scrambling quarterback Carter Nye passed for more than 6,100 yards and 59 touchdowns, helping Bentonville win a conference championship and make consecutive state title game appearances. Bentonville's Carter Nye. Drake Lindsay, Fayetteville. 6'5", 220-pound quarterback Drake Lindsay was Fayetteville's coach on the field and its undeniable field general. Lindsay stepped into a starting spot last fall, standing tall in the pocket and passing for almost 3,800 yards and 37 touchdowns. The junior led Fayetteville to a conference runner-up finish. This fall, he owned the offense and delivered passes with consistency. In a midseason showdown with Rogers, Drake dominated, passing for 538 yards and 6 touchdowns as Fayetteville notched a 47-42 win. 2 weeks later, Lindsay lofted perfect passes, connecting on 16 of them for 250 yards and 5 TDs as Fayetteville earned a conference championship with a 21-point win over Bentonville. And on the first Saturday in December, Drake completed 27 passes for 355 yards, earning state title game MVP honors after becoming the only Class 7A quarterback with more than 50 touchdown passes. In 2 seasons as Fayetteville signal caller, Drake Lindsay passed for 8,500 yards, 95 touchdowns,
propelling the Purple Dogs to 20 wins and a state title. Fayetteville's Drake Lindsay. Mitorian Singleton Bryant. People in Saline County always knew he was a playmaker, and Mitorian Singleton never let them down. As a sophomore, Singleton had more than 1,200 yards, and he caught the winning touchdown pass with 14 seconds left at Conway, giving Bryant a come-from-behind conference championship victory. A month later, Singleton caught a key fourth down pass in the final minutes to keep a drive alive, then skied over Fayetteville's secondary to grab the winning touchdown pass with less than 2 minutes left, helping Bryant win its fourth consecutive state championship. Wearing number 3 as a junior, Singleton amassed more than 800 yards receiving. He scored 2 touchdowns against Bentonville as Bryant won its 5th straight state championship. Battling an ankle injury this fall, Singleton still had more than 900 yards and scored 12 touchdowns in a 5th straight conference championship season for the Hornets. In his career, Bryant's playmaker had almost 3,000 yards and 21 touchdowns, helping Bryant win 34 games, 3 conference titles, and 2 state championships. Bryant's Mitorian Singleton.
And Mitorian, you probably gave me the greatest advice ever that you didn't even know that you gave it to me. It was before the Conway-Bryant game, we picked Conway. You asked me, you said, hey, Hootens, I see you pick them. Remember this? And I said, does that make you angry? And he said, your opinions of others don't really matter. Or your opinion is not my concern. And now I've kind of words to live by. But the 7A Offensive Player of the Year, the Farm Bureau 7A Offensive Player of the Year, goes to Drake Lindsay, Fayetteville. And he was correct. We did not pick that game right.
Class 7A Defensive Player of the Year, Ben Pearson, Bentonville. Meet Ben Pearson, Bentonville's hype guy and the Tigers' top defensive lineman the past 2 seasons. As an undersized junior, Pearson pressured quarterbacks and split blocks to make tackles in the backfield. He earned All-State honors as the Tigers won 9 games and advanced to the state title game for the first time in 5 seasons. Wearing number 9 this fall, Pearson powered Bentonville's defense. He made 5 tackles in the semifinals at Bryant. A week later, Pearson piled up 6 stops in the state championship game against rival Fayetteville. In 3 action-packed seasons, Bentonville's relentless defensive end, Ben Pearson, made more than 120 tackles, 25 sacks, and forced 7 turnovers, helping Bentonville win 28 games with a conference title and back-to-back appearances in the state title game. Bentonville's Ben Pearson. Drake Fowler, Bryant. Bryant's best athlete was a 4-year starter for the basketball team and a decathlete on the track, but Drake Fowler's presence was most notable on the football field. As a ball-hawking sophomore, he earned a starting safety spot by breaking up passes. Finished that season with 6 interceptions, returning this one for a crucial touchdown in the state title game against Fayetteville. In an All-State junior season, Fowler became a threat returning punts, and he made 60 tackles, contributing to Bryant's 5th straight state title. Wearing number 0 as a senior, Drake Fowler's interception in the end zone at Conway sparked Bryant to another conference championship. In his 2-time All-State career, Bryant's Drake Fowler made almost 150 tackles, 16 interceptions, and set school records for punt return yardage, helping the Hornets to 34 wins and 2 state championships. Bryant's Drake Fowler. Caden Spencer, Fayetteville.
Caden Spencer wasn't your typical lumbering defensive lineman. Instead, he made highly athletic plays at pivotal moments, usually in the opponent's backfield. Spencer started fast this season with 4 tackles and 2 sacks against Cabot. A month later, he took up residence in the Rogers backfield, making sacks and tackles for loss to help Fayetteville to a 5-point win. 2 weeks later, he had 7 tackles in the conference title game against Bentonville. And in the state championship game, Caden Spencer was all over War Memorial Stadium, making 6 tackles and 3 TFLs, including 1 sack. In an all-state senior season, Fayetteville's most acrobatic defensive lineman, Caden Spencer, made 92 tackles, 39 tackles for loss, and 10 sacks, leading the Purple Dogs to 13 wins and a state championship. Fayetteville's Caden Spencer.
Coach Casey Dick calls Caden Spencer the best athlete he's ever coached. Drake Fowler leads Bryant's school records for interceptions and career punt return yards, and he only started returning punts last year. Ben Pearson, the fumble you've caused right before, and I guess in the second quarter of the state championship game. Yes. And then you give it back the next play. But your celebration was great. It was, that was tough. That was a great foot. The Farm Bureau Insurance 7A Defensive Player of the Year goes to Drake Fowler, Bryant. Now we've got the 7A, 6A coaches. They're combined, so in the same category.
Class 6A, 7A, Coach of the Year. Casey Dick, Fayetteville.
A loss in the final minutes of the 2021 state championship game only fueled Fayetteville and Coach Casey Dick. 2 years later, the Purple Dogs were better equipped for a state title run, and Coach Dick enjoyed every moment. The season started with a 22-point win over Cabot in the opener. 5 weeks later, Fayetteville put up almost 600 yards and won a shootout over Rogers. Junior receiver Jason Delamar caught 13 passes for 176 yards, and senior Mason Spencer had 3 touchdown receptions, helping Fayetteville to a 47-42 win. 2 weeks after that, Fayetteville leaned on its running game and senior Christian Setzer to wear down Bentonville and give the Purple Dogs only their 2nd outright conference championship since 1963. And in the state championship game rematch with Bentonville, Fayetteville turned to its defense. The Purple Dogs gave up just 2 touchdowns to win their 13th game of the season and first state championship since 2016. Fayetteville's Casey Dick.
Chris Young, Greenwood.
The victory margins were such for the 2023 Greenwood Bulldogs that 3 touchdown wins were considered close games. That's one reason Coach Chris Young considers the Bulldogs one of the state's more dominant teams in recent history. Offensively, sophomore quarterback Kane Archer completed 73% of his passes, accounted for 3,100 yards and a numbing 49 touchdowns. Senior receiver L.J. Robbins and junior Grant Carnes combined for more than 2,000 yards and 30 touchdowns as the Bulldogs averaged 50 points a week while scoring touchdowns on 67% of their drives. The defense was just as deft, holding 7 opponents to 2 touchdowns or less and forcing 33 turnovers. In the state championship game, Greenwood's defense had 4 sacks and 3 interceptions. In 4 years since he became the Greenwood coach, Chris Young's teams have won 46 games, 3 conference championships, and 2 state titles. Greenwood's Chris Young.
Jody Grant, Bentonville.
Bentonville's Jody Grant has learned to navigate the expectations of coaching one of the 7A West's most reliable programs. His Tigers have 77 victories and 6 conference titles the past 9 seasons. Last fall, Grant's Tigers rode a solid defense to a conference championship and advanced to their first state title game since 2017. Grant's high-powered offense put up 44 points a game this fall. 9 Tiger receivers caught touchdown passes, and the defense held 3 teams to a touchdown or less. Grant worked a masterpiece in the semifinals when the Tigers outscored Bryant by 17 points in the second half, ending Bryant its first loss to an Arkansas Class 7A team in 6 years. A week later, Bentonville's stingy defense held Fayetteville to a season-low 22 points and just 5 yards rushing total as the Tigers made their second consecutive state title game appearance. Bentonville's Jody Grant.
Coach Casey Dick, that woman in there cheering, that was his wife, Miss Dick. Yes, yeah. I didn't use the one that I sent you earlier where you were yelling at the ref to throw the flag. Okay. Coach Jody Grant, in the semifinals got the win versus Bryant on his birthday. That was pretty impressive. And Coach Young, speaking of, we were talking about earlier Parkview being young. Have you looked at their roster? I'd like to see a Parkview Greenwood matchup next year, week 0, if you don't want to talk about it. So the Farm Bureau 7A 6A Coach of the Year goes to Casey Dick, Fatal. Let's make it happen. And now the best category, the Offensive Lineman of the Year.
Offensive Lineman of the Year. Jonas Nance, Shiloh Christian.
Opposing coaches call 6 foot, 4 inch Jonas Nance one of Shiloh Christian's top offensive weapons, even though he never touched the ball. Nance played offensive tackle with a nasty streak, driving defenders backward and finishing blocks. The Saints ran behind Nance for an average of 131 yards a week. Jonas Nance paved the way in the second half of the semifinals against Pine Bluff, opening up running lanes and allowing the Saints to score 30 points in that half and earn a come-from-behind victory. Then in the state title game, Nance sealed off Little Rock Parkview linemen to clear the way. In an all-state senior season, Nance was a key reason that Shiloh Christian averaged 45 points per game. In 3 years, All-State right tackle Jonas Nance helped Shiloh Christian achieve 37 wins and 3 consecutive state title game appearances. Shiloh Christian's Jonas Nance.
Alex Martin, Parkview.
Alex Martin was appointed Little Rock Parkview's team captain because he lifted teammates emotionally and physically. For 3 seasons, Martin cleared running lanes from his offensive tackle spot. As a junior, he helped the Patriots to 12 wins and their first state championship in more than 40 years. This fall, Martin anchored the line for an offense that averaged 47 points per game. He pancaked defenders and rarely came off the field, also racking up 4 sacks and 19 tackles for a defense that held opponents to a touchdown or less. In his career, 2-time All-State lineman Alex Martin helped Parkview to 35 wins and 2 state titles. Little Rock Parkview's Alex Martin.
Trayson Hunt, Bentonville.
Trayson Hunt played just like his name, hunting and tossing defensive linemen. Hunt's nifty footwork kept defenses away from the ball. As a junior, the 6 foot 5 inch offensive tackle led Bentonville to 11 wins, a conference championship, and a state runner-up finish. This fall, Trayson Hunt was one of the 7A West's top linemen.
He used proper technique to protect his quarterback, and his blocks in open space helped the Tigers churn out yards between the tackles. Bentonville All-State right tackle Trayson Hunt recorded 56 knockdown blocks and earned a blocking grade of 87%, helping the Tigers to 9 wins and another trip to the state championship game. Bentonville's Trayson Hunt.
So Coach Grant at Bentonville gave a pancake award for the most pancakes, and Trayson won it every week. Alex Martin could have been a defensive finalist if Coach Boulding needed him at all. You know, you just see him on the side. He was probably the most excited for all those players when they went and scored a touchdown. He was the first one down there throwing them up. And Jonas Nance did not allow a sack all year. Zero. That's impressive. This is a great group of offensive linemen. This is the first award we've had, and I'm very excited. It's in the 2023 Farm Bureau Offensive Lineman of the Year goes to Jonas Nance, Shiloh Christian. Before we end tonight, we have an overall Player of the Year award, but I just want to say thank you for all letting us be a part of your lives. Y'all were my first class, y'all as sophomores as Hootens, so I got to watch you grow and develop and watch your good and bad games, and so it's you know, I've gotten to know you through that, you know, the coaches, and we really appreciate that y'all let us be a part of this. And the 2023 overall Player of the Year is Jalen Dupree, Malvern. Now, Mr. Mac Wallace is gonna come talk, and he is kind of running the show, and I appreciate he's with Farm Bureau, and he's got some closing remarks, and we hope you enjoyed the show. We worked extremely hard. Bates, amazing job on the videos. Unbelievable. Stand up. You're the man. Great job. This is his first time. Only getting better. Mr. Mac Wallace.
Okay, I'm going to do a magic trick. We're going to disappear in about 30 seconds. I know y'all get, hey, thank you for the applause back there. I appreciate that. On a serious note and a heartfelt, I want to congratulate all the players and coaches that have been honored tonight. It's an honor for Farm Bureau to be involved with Hootens and continue our partnership to recognize top high school football players and coaches across this great state. We didn't have anything like this when I was coming through high school. Not that I would have been, singled out. I mean, some people say you didn't even have face masks when you were in high school. But, yeah, we did, just to clarify. Teammates matter. And these are individual awards for outstanding performance in a team sport. And none of us in sports or in business or in life could have any level of success without a good teammates. You can only be as good as they can be, and they can only be as good as you can be. So I wish you would take this recognition back home and celebrate it, celebrate the recognition and honor with the people that comprise your team. So on behalf of the entire Farm Bureau family, we congratulate you again. God bless you. Good night. Safe travels.